In this tutorial, we're going to look at the process of automated area takeoff in InfoWorks ICM. Automated area takeoff is the process where we assign areas from roads and roofs to subcatchments automatically. The roads and the roofs will typically have come from GIS layers such as ArcGIS or MapInfo. The network in front of us currently has a boundary indicating the overall area of the catchment. Our first step is to select that area of the catchment and then to divide it up using a mathematical technique called Thesian polygons so that each manhole that you can see has its own individual subcatchment. We do that using the model menu and subcatchment and create within selected polygon. We select our system type. We can define individual manholes if we wish, but we need to do the whole network and press OK. Immediately, the overall area is divided up, and you can now see that within the network there are distinct boundaries for each node in the system. And if we select a particular polygon, say this one here in the center, we can see that that area now has been divided up, and everything happening within that area will drain to this particular manhole in the center of the screen. Let's zoom to our particular selected catchment. If we now look at the details of that catchment, we can see that for this particular subcatchment, there are in fact an area of 1.7 hectares, and at the moment, none of that area has been assigned to particular runoff surfaces. So all the runoff surfaces are at the moment zero. However, what we can do is to utilize the GIS layer that we can see beneath this picture, where we can see the buildings and we can see the roads. We can utilize that area, we can read it directly from InfoWorks, into InfoWorks from the GIS system. All we need to do is to tell the software that we wish to update our contributing areas based on our GIS layer. So that data will come from the geoplan. So having set our flag, we then simply go model and subcatchment and area takeoff. Specify our layer, which is our roads and roofs in our GIS layer. Specify that the status information is coming from the attributes in that GIS, and we have a status attribute of R for roofs and BR for roads. Specify that only catchments with the #G flag will be updated, and press OK. The software will now read in the GIS layer, and we can see that the layer is called roads and roofs. So that layer is initially added completely. Depending on the size of the layer, that can take just a few moments to do. With that done, the software will check the authenticity of the data and make sure there are no errors. If there are, then they'll be reported in the log file. And you can see here that, in fact, if it does find tiny errors, they will be ignored. That area process was correct. We can shut down the report and now draw our attention to the area at the bottom left-hand corner of the screen here, where we can see that now, rather than having zero areas, we now have distinct data for the roads, for the roofs, and for the remaining areas, the pervious areas. And we can see quite clearly looking at this that we have a significant increase in area 2 over area 1. And that is in fact that the roads are area 1, the roofs area 2, and the remaining area is area 3. Now in this example, we just updated a single subcatchment. Well, we could repeat that process for every single subcatchment in the model, and they can all be done at once, so there's no need to do it one at a time. And very quickly you can see how we can go from a situation where we just have the area boundary selected to having the entire catchment divided up into individual catchments, and then those catchments populated with specific data for roads, roofs, and remaining pervious areas. That completes this tutorial, where we were looking at the automated area takeoff functionality in InfoWorks ICM.